position of the myotomes of the lower limb, we will start with L2, which is hip flexion. For hip flexion with the patient from the supine position, we start with the hip in neutral abduction, neutral rotation, slight flexion, so around 15 degrees of hip and knee flexion. The therapist is holding the patient's limb. And now we want to do the movement for grade 3. So this is a movement against the gravity. We will ask the patient to bend their hip, bring the knee towards the chest. Yep. And whenever we test patients, especially with thoracolumbar lesions, we definitely avoid moving beyond 90 degrees of hip flexion. Why we need to avoid that? Because doing excessive flexion will place extra pressure on the lumbar spine. And for a patient with thoracolumbar lesions, we need to avoid that. Now, if the patient is able to do this movement until 90 degrees, then this is grade 3. Moving on to grades 4 and 5, we start from the end position actually. So we will go into 90 degrees of hip flexion. The patient is going to be at 90 degrees of hip flexion. The therapist will provide resistance for further hip flexion, making sure we don't allow movement more than 90 degrees. And the stabilization will be on the ASIS. So from this position, and I will move my hand down here to this position, I want you to try to bring your knee towards your chest, but please first move it to 90 degrees. Okay, now bend your knee, bend, and I resist. If the maximum the patient can do is the moderate resistance, then this is grade 4. And if the maximum they can do is maximum resistance, then it's grade 5. As always, we avoid prolonged contraction so that the patient doesn't hold, and that the patient holds their breath. We avoid this. Okay, relax. If the patient is unable to do grade 3 hip flexion, we will do the movement in gravity eliminated position. As always, for patients with spinal cord injury, we need to stay in the supine position. So how do we do hip flexion with the gravity eliminated from supine position? Basically, we will have the patient externally rotate the leg, or we will do that. We will externally rotate the leg and flex the hip 45 degrees and 90 degrees at the knee. Now, in this position, and we will hold the limb to remove any friction with the bed. In this position, if the patient attempts to bring their knee towards the trunk to sideways, try to do the movement, please. Yeah, keep it close to the bed. Don't raise it off. Close to the bed. Okay? If the patient is able to do this movement, then this is hip flexion with the gravity eliminated position. If they could do the full range, then this is grade 2. If the patient is unable to do the full range, then we need to palpate the hip flexors. Actually, the primary hip flexor is iliopsoas, which is too deep to palpate. So we will try to palpate the superficial muscles. To do the movement here, we will be supporting the leg to reduce the flexion, and the palpation, we will do it at the ASIS. And here, as we said, the iliopsoas is too deep to palpate. So we are primarily palpating the superficial muscles, like rectus femoris, for example. And if the patient attempts to, if we see any contraction, or if we palpate anything here, then this would be grade 1. When doing the hip flexion, we need to pay attention to other trunk muscles that might substitute for the hip flexion. For example, the abdominal muscles or the quadratus lumborum. And we can avoid being confused with these by properly observing the correct movement and avoiding any substitution.